I have been dead silent on the Chiefs this whole year because I didn't quite believe the idea that the Chiefs were dead. I mean, they were 3-3 going to week 7, but their losses were to the Bills, the Ravens, and the Chargers, all very good teams that were all 4-1 after 5 weeks, even though this is slightly concerning because these are all AFC teams that they'll have to beat if they want to make it to a third straight Super Bowl. But after their last loss to the Titans, we need to talk about some things because this wasn't a loss, this was an embarrassment from beginning to end, so we need to unpack some things and finally talk about the Chiefs. Now, are the Chiefs dead? Absolutely not, but there are a lot of things that we saw that are very worrisome. They were exposed even more and cannot continue if they want to contend and even make the playoffs at this point. And that is not an exaggeration. In the AFC, there's 7 spots available now. They're competing against the Bills, Ravens, Browns, Chargers, Raiders, Titans, and shit, even the Bengals at this point. Having a losing record going into week 8 and Mahomes having to leave the game to a hit to the head is worrisome. So right now, we're going to take a collection of plays live together that are clearly uncharacteristics of the Chiefs and their lowlights of this game. And then after, we'll talk about what their biggest problems are, what they need to fix, and how they should go about it. So we're going to go over these plays live together, and the Titans scored on their first 2 possessions. You can see the score is 14-0 already, and this throw right here is where everything kind of started to unravel, so let's get into it. Drops back, and he just misses him, throws it right at his feet. That's not the read we want. You're going to drop back. He's going to roll out to the left, trying to make something happen. Down 17-0, trying to force it before the half, and intercepted. That is a terrible, terrible decision, terrible throw. But this is your time. Down 24-0 now. This is your time to get... Actually, let's go back. He's trying to escape the pocket so much in this game. Look at his feet right here. He has a clear escape to the right, and I just feel like this was a very lazy play by his feet. He doesn't move his feet at all. He stays right there, tries to sidearm it, get it to him. It's just not even close. But this is where compounding mistakes happen. This is where it hurts you the most. This is your chance to score, get the ball at half, and try and score again, and you fumble it. Just compounding mistakes that just happen over and over and over. They get the ball to start the second half, and now they're driving, and you're not going to get the flag when you overthrow him by 15 yards. This is a terrible throw. He's just not right in the mindset right now. All right, he's going to roll out to the right, and nobody home. Okay, well, and right at the feet, that's the wrong read. Travis Kelce Williams is wide open right there. You got to hit it, but he can't launch it. He can throw a country mile. This is your last chance to get back in the game, and overthrows him by about a mile, not even close. This one, he tries to do a no-look pass for honestly no reason and just absolutely dirts it. Nothing was going right for them. So after all of that, obviously this is a specific collection of lowlights. They did make some plays in this game, but they could never string together a full drive and never reach the end zone once. But before we talk about their offense, we need to talk about their defense because it is absolutely atrocious. They are worst or second to worst in almost every statistical category that matters. Rushing yards, passing yards, points allowed, etc. If one team has a game plan and comes in, they want to run the ball, they're going to do it. If they want to throw it all over them, they can do that as well. If they need a stop, they don't get it, and it's very important to know because it is a big part of why they struggled offensively in this game. Nothing can throw your offensive game plan off more than getting in a deficit early. But this is nothing new for the Chiefs. Even in their Super Bowl run, they were down 24-0 against the Texans. They were down 10-17 points against the Titans. They were down 10 points in the fourth quarter in the Super Bowl that they won. They were able to come back with these lightning in a bottle plays, 2-3 play drives with Tyreek, Sammy Watkins, Travis Kelce would bust the coverage wide open and score in a minute or two. But now teams are starting to get the idea how to combat this. The teams are starting to play too high and keep everything in front of them. They know that their chances are better betting on the Chiefs getting impatient, making a mistake, not getting a first down, or getting a coverage sack with the front four. Which brings me to my first point. This is where I can really start to blame Mahomes, because I realize a lot of the time he's on the run, extending plays, avoiding sacks, making these throws on the run. Well, he's developed this really bad habit of taking these super long dropbacks. He will be 5 yards deep in the gun already, and then he will drop back another 5 to 8 yards instead of staying in the pocket. For reference, here's the best in the business at it. Here's Tom Brady, the best pocket passer and pocket presence in NFL history. Look how he gets the ball, stays composed, buys time if he needs to, adjusting to the defense, keeping his eyes downfield. If he needs to step up, slide left, slide right, or not move at all, that's exactly what he does. Whereas Mahomes is taking these massive dropbacks, trying to get the long shot that isn't going to be there because of the defense that they're playing, and he's getting instant pressure and has to play backyard football almost every other play. Now, it's not every time, but in this game, it seemed to happen enough to force a bad throw or an ultimately stack that stalled out every single drive. Again, not making excuses for their super shitty defense, but they need to also find a way to incorporate the run game. And yes, the run game, the story is old as time. Positive safe yards, control the time of possession, open up play action, make the defense commit more to the box. This is exactly what happened in the Super Bowl against the Bucks, and other teams have committed this formula when they play the Chiefs. Don't let the Chiefs' run game get going. Stick to too high and let them throw into favorable coverages for the defense. And now this is where it falls on Andy Reid and Patrick Mahomes. They need to step back and say, okay, this is how it's going to be. Mahomes needs to know that since he became a starter, he's been boy wonder, the next great thing. He can make any 70-yard throw off his back foot, escape anything, and make any sort of comeback. And he has deserved it because he did it time and time again. But this isn't going to be sustainable game to game, season to season. You can't make all these runs. He needs to start playing more like an Aaron Rodgers or a Tom Brady, more veteran quarterbacks. You're going to dirt the ball. You're going to throw it away. You're going to take every single check down if the defense is giving it to you, and then throw the Ferrari into fifth gear and let one rip over the top for 70, 80 yards, or have the ability to convert a third and 18 if you get a penalty and you really need to. This is the recipe for long-term success, and this is what Josh Allen has been implementing more and more into his game, and he's had a lot of success being this boring little Prius and then putting it into drive and being a sports car all in one. So in conclusion, the Chiefs are not dead. They are beyond talented. They have an insane quarterback, a genius coach, all the talent in the world on offense, and can turn it around 180, make the playoffs, and be one of the best teams in the NFL again. But what I'm pointing out in this video are the things that they need to change if they even want to make the playoffs at this point. Because not only were they losing to really, really good teams, the Titans are also a very good team, but they got embarrassed. And when if they play football like that, they're going to lose to teams that are worse than them. You can't turn the ball over like that. You can't not get a run game going like that. And I'm not even sure what they're going to do with their defense because it almost seems like nothing is going right for that side of the ball. But also, this was not supposed to bury the Chiefs, but rather be constructive criticism on what I think they should do moving forward. But let me know what you guys think. I have been dead silent on the Chiefs so far this year because, I mean, all four of their losses, I know they're having a losing record going into week 8, all four of their losses are against very, very good teams. But that's really not an excuse, because if you're supposed to be the best of the best and you're going to want to win another Super Bowl, you have to beat the best teams, and every great team they've played, they've lost to so far. So they need to fix these things, but I want to know what you guys think. What do you think the Chiefs' biggest problem is? What do you think they need to fix? Are they dead? Am I overreacting thinking they can turn it around, or do you think they actually can? Let me know down in the comments. Make sure to like this video if you like videos like these. Comment down below what you think, and make sure to subscribe if you enjoy daily sports content. I love and appreciate y'all so much. Thank you so much for checking out the channel, and I will see you all tomorrow. Peace!